love the ISUPK. Stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by Commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.
Your Christian pastors are not preparing you for what's about to happen in America. Your Christian pastors are not telling you to stock up on food, to change your life, because God is about to destroy this place. They're not telling you that. Guess what? If you Black, Hispanic, and Native American, the ISUPK under Commanding General Yohanna is coming out here to tell you what you need to know about these end times. So many of us grew up in Christian homes, and we heard our mamas and grandmamas, God is coming back, baby. He's coming back. We in the last days. We in the end times. I'm gonna prove to you today, right now, that we are in fact living in the end times, man. And you know what's so sad? We don't even know it because the Christian church is too busy lying to Black people. The Christian church has gotten rich off of Black people, but we don't have leaders to speak on our behalf. We still believe that we can go and vote and some white man is gonna change our conditions in the ghetto. That's a lie, man. And we believe this lie because of the people that we look to for leadership have failed us, man. Guess what? Black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man, we love you so much, we gonna tell you the truth, even if it offends you. I understand, I was offended too. I was on the other side and heard these things. And I heard that I was God's chosen. And I heard the white man was the devil, according to the Bible. And I was offended too. But guess what? The moment I picked up this book and actually read it and came to class, I couldn't be offended no more because it's the truth. And guess what? Let God's words be true and every man a liar, man. Let's read. Give me Matthew 16 and 1. I'm gonna prove to you that Black people are living in the end times. This way of life in America is coming to an end. And the signs are all around us, man. Everywhere we look, it's showing that God is going to destroy this place. They had the Million MAGA March here in DC, where these racists came out and destroyed this place, beating up Black women. These people are so hate. The white man is such a coward. Only a coward beats up a woman, man. Only a coward, that's who they are. That's who we look to for trust. That's who we look to execute judgment. Cowards. People who are the most unrighteous in this place. They had a police sheriff in Massachusetts who was soliciting minors for sex. This is the chief of police. And this is a man who we look to for justice. And he's so disgusting behind closed doors. That's our lives in America, man. We are in the last days, and the Bible says that. Read that.
The book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 1. The Pharisees also came with the Sadducees and tempting desire with them.
So what we're reading about right here is the Sadducees and the Pharisees. And that will be your modern day Christian pastors, your modern day imams, your modern day religious leaders of the Black community. Everything that we experience in America today, we have experienced before, Black man. We have experienced before. And we're reading about how our so-called religious leaders came to Christ. You understand? Read.
And tempting desire him that he would shew them a sign from heaven. He answered and said unto them, when it is evening, ye say it will be their weather.
So what we're reading about is the religious leaders of the time came to Christ. And they asked Christ, show us a sign. What is the signs of the heavens? Meaning this, everybody since the beginning of time wanted to know when is the end? When is the end? If you read in these scriptures, the disciples came to Christ many times asking, when is the end? And the Sadducees and Pharisees, the religious leaders, came to Christ and asking them to show him a sign, to show them a sign. Read that again.
When it is evening, ye say, it will be fair weather, for the sky is red.
Christ said, when it is evening, it will be fair weather, for the sky is red. I'm going to break it down in just a second. Follow me. Read.
And in the morning, it will be fair weather today, for the sky is red and lowering.
So right now, Christ is giving them an analogy. He's saying, you can tell what the weather is going to be like when you look in the sky. Isn't that true today? You can look up in the sky and see clouds and know it's going to rain later on. You can come outside. A lot of us that's from the country, you can come outside and smell the rain. You can smell the air. I'm like, yeah, it's going to rain later on. And that's what Christ is saying. He's giving them the analogy that you can easily look in the sky and know what the weather's going to be like. Keep reading.
Oh, ye hypocrite.
Oh, ye what?
Hypocrite.
Ye what?
Hypocrite.
Christ called the religious leaders of that time hypocrites, man. The people that black people are making rich when we go to their churches every Sunday to be lied to. The people who tell us it's okay to celebrate Thanksgiving when it's the murder of our Native American brothers. The people who told us the law is done away with. The people that have been lying to black people. Christ called them hypocrites, man. He called them hypocrites because they did not do what they preached. And that is no different than today. You got Christian pastors talking about holy this and holy that and righteousness this and righteousness that. And they touching boys, sleeping with people's women, stealing money from the church, raping women. All type of atrocities happen in these black churches. And we don't speak about it because we have the pastors in such a high regard. When we should be honest and keep it real, the pastors are the most disgusting people in the black community. That church is nothing more than a whorehouse that has destroyed our black and Hispanic brothers, man. Them Catholic priests are absolutely disgusting, man. But we continue to go to the churches and go to the mosque and go to the Catholic church because we think we can find truth there. Well, Christ is telling us you are not going to find the truth in the church, in the mosque, in the Catholic church, man. Christ is telling us the truth right here. He called the Sadducees and Pharisees hypocrites. Keep reading.
Ye can discern the face of the sky, but ye not discern the signs of the time.
Christ is saying to these religious leaders, you can discern the face of the sky, meaning you can tell what the weather is going to be like by the sky, but you can't tell what's going to happen by what's going on right now. I'll give you a perfect example. The news channel always reports how America is more polarized than before, than it has ever been. Anybody that watches the news, you hear about it all the time. The left versus the right. Democrats versus Republicans. Blue versus red. The Proud Boys is threatening to take over America if Donald Trump doesn't become president. You have white nationalists threatening to kidnap the governor of Michigan and Virginia. This place is polarized now more than ever. I bet you didn't know that was prophesied in the Bible. America being against each other is prophesied in the Bible. Don't worry, we're going to get into it. Keep reading.
Verse 4, a wicked and adulterous generation.
A wicked and adulterous generation, man. Because we follow the Christian church, we have become a wicked and adulterous generation, man. Our people have become wicked following after America. We believe it's okay for two men to lay down with each other. We believe it's okay for children to be molested. We believe it's okay for our people to get high when God says that is wicked, man. But you know who allows the wickedness? America. America allows everything that God says is wrong to thrive in this place. And that's why God is going to destroy America. God is going to absolutely clean this place with fire because of the sin and the wickedness that has been allowed to thrive in this place, man. Keep reading.
Seek him after a sign, and there shall no sign be given unto it.
Christ is saying, you are a wicked and adulterous generation that seeketh after a sign. Christ is saying, but no sign shall be given unto it. Keep reading.
But the sign of the prophet Jonah.
But the sign of the prophet Jonah, man. Meaning, Christians always want to see a miracle. That's why the Christian church gets so rich, because us in the Christian church want to see a sign. We want to go to church and see magic tricks. We think God is a magician because our life is so hellish, man. We are oppressed in this place that we look for anything to take away our pain. We look for anything. That's why so many of our grandmothers went and bought that holy water, that prayer cloth. You understand? Being hustled. Knowing that it doesn't do anything, but it makes us feel good because we live in so much poverty and hell in America. So we look for a sign. When Christ is telling us that is wicked and adulterous, man, that is wrong. And that's why we're destroyed in this place. Christ said the sign we will have is the sign of the prophet Jonah, man. What's the sign of the prophet of Jonah? Christ told Jonah to go to Nineveh and tell them that I'm going to destroy this place if they don't turn from their ways. And guess what the ISUPK does? We've been coming out in the streets of America since 1969 and telling Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, separate from America because God is going to destroy this place. God is going to destroy America, and you don't want to be part of this destruction, man. That's the sign that Christ told them you will get. And guess what? Every time you see us coming out on these corners, you better understand that we are getting closer and closer to the return of our King. Because this is a sign of the last days. You want to see a sign, you're looking at it right here.
Sparks Beats. I roll with warriors and them garments be looking glorious. Feel like 20 sets of fists hitting you, but it's four of us. They always scream squad, but loyalty just mean more to us. Let the 40s bust when it's time, unleash the hunters. I done seen stand up niggas turn into runners. Niggas with weak right hooks turn into gunners. Soldiers in abundance, marching in by the hundreds. We don't hold no punches, we letting them go in bunches. Crawled up out the dungeons and now we do it humongous. Waiting on a hater to flex, we doing lunges. Rappers better give me respect, this beat punished. Really, I don't worry about credit or where it's due. Just know your favorite rapper told it, I'm number two. Camp full of animals like I'm running the zoo. Call me Tower Warhorn, either call me the Jew. Shit, you can call me the king, I'm ready to rule. Only sharks swim here, rappers get out the pool. Only real spitters can wade in this type of water. A renaissance coming, we cutting your time shorter. You had a good while to get your affairs in order.